Sienna, where are you? We're supposed to celebrate your birthday today, right? I'm here at our parents' house, just as they asked me to be. They can't seem to find you either.
What? A birthday party for me at our parents' place today? I don't recall hearing about that.
Really? How could that be?
Actually, I'm with Mom and Dad right now. We're at a lovely hotel by the lake celebrating my birthday. Are you sure you got the details right? You do tend to mix things up.
Wait, what? I wasn't informed about any of this. Mom specifically told me to bring you your present and come to the house. That's exactly what she said.
Oh, classic Mom. She must have forgotten to tell you about the change in plans. She's sitting next to me right now and admits she forgot to inform you.
So, what am I supposed to do now?
Well, we're all here. You can just head back home if you want. Just leave my present on the dining room table. Thanks for coming, though. Safe travels back home, sis.
Wait a minute. You're doing this on purpose, aren't you? This is the third time it's happened.
What are you talking about? You're being paranoid.
This happened on Dad's birthday and Mom's birthday, too. It's not funny anymore.
Whoa, calm down. Why are you getting so worked up?
I'm tired of being treated like this by all of you. It's always been the same story since we were kids. It's always been you, Mom and Dad, and then there's me. But now that we're older, it's gotten even worse. It's downright cruel sometimes.
Oh no, not another lecture. Delaney's upset again, haha.
All you guys seem to want from me is a present, so I'll just leave it here. But stop wasting my time with this passive-aggressive stuff, and just be honest if you don't want me around.
Oh, come on, sis. We can't say that to family.
Your actions are saying it loud and clear, and pass that message on to Mom and Dad, too. If they don't want me around, then they shouldn't invite me anymore.
Don't be such a party pooper, Delaney. We all have our roles to play in this family drama.
Excuse me? Say that again.
What can I say? I'm sorry I was born cuter and more charming than you, sis. But thanks to you being so plain and socially awkward, Mom and Dad appreciate how awesome I am even more. So please don't stop coming to family gatherings.
Are you trying to pick a fight with me? Because that's what it sounds like.
No, of course not. I'd never do that. I'm sincerely saying that I'm really glad that you are the way you are. Because that's the reason why I get all the love, all the gifts, and all the guys. And it's obvious that Mom and Dad totally enjoy spoiling me and messing with you too. That's also important. I mean, in this weird way, doing what we do to you always brings the three of us closer together. We have to thank you for us being so close. Weird, right? Like I said, we all have our parts to play.
Wow, you have truly sunk to a new low today. I mean, I can't even... How can you even think of any of that? Let alone say it to my face? It's just beyond me.
Anyway, we'll be hanging out here and we'll definitely bring back some good souvenirs, as usual. I bet you've never been to a place like this, huh? Nobody to go with, I bet. Am I right?
You can give it a rest now, sis. You're going to wear yourself out thinking so hard about new ways to insult me. And yeah, I do have friends and I've been to places like that, for your information. As a matter of fact, I took that kind of trip just last month. It was great.
No way. You're lying for sure. No way do you have someone to take a trip with. The next thing you're going to tell me is that you went with a guy. Haha, there's no way that happened. No way do you have a boyfriend.
Why wouldn't I have a boyfriend? You're not nearly as smart as you think you are, Sienna. Have a good birthday weekend without me. Your presence on the dining room table. Bye.
Delaney, is this true? I need to ask you myself. Do you really have a boyfriend? Sienna just told me.
Yeah, why? I'm not used to you showing any interest in me or my life. Why are you asking now?
Oh, I'm just surprised, that's all. Can you really blame me? It's just hard to believe anyone would date you. What with your looks and personality and all? I mean, even as your mother, it's obvious that you don't have much in those departments.
You know, Mom, it really amazes me that you can talk to your own daughter like that. It's really and truly amazing to me. And you've been doing it to me my whole life, ever since I was a kid, calling me ugly and insulting me. And you raised Sienna to do the same.
Well, I'm your parent, so I have to tell you the truth. I'd be doing you a disservice otherwise. I mean, there's nothing worse than an ugly girl who thinks she's cute, you know? Nobody likes one of those.
Good Lord, Mom. You are just too much. Tell me who hurt you when you were a child. You're supposed to treat your children equally, don't you think? I have actually really had it up to here with you and Dad. There's a limit to what any sane human can take.
Oh? Is that so? What are you even talking about?
What I'm talking about is how you constantly dote on Sienna and treat me like I'm an unwanted outsider and a nuisance. It was bad enough when we were kids. But nothing has changed now that we're grown and I've had enough of it. Am I really that unlovable? Really? I'm sincerely asking you, Mom. I'm your child. Your flesh and blood, too, just as much as she is. Can you not understand at all how constantly being told that I'm ugly and uninteresting makes me feel?
Don't be ridiculous. With looks like yours, you really should have a much thicker skin. No parent loves their children unconditionally just because they're supposed to. That's a complete myth. So yeah, you're my child, but ugly is still ugly. I can't do anything about it but be honest with you. And nobody loves ugly.
I can't even... Why are you like this?
But whatever. Enough about this stupid stuff. Let's get back to the matter at hand, which is this boyfriend of yours. Tell me all about him. I'm thinking he can't be good looking if he's dating you. Am I right? And let me say this up front. I hate fatties, so don't even tell me if that's what he is. No fatties are allowed.
Well, Mom, I don't know your taste in men, but to me, he's a great guy. And he's not fat. He's kind and caring, and he's there for me 24/7 when I need a friend, no matter what the situation is.
Well, isn't that special? Don't get cocky, dear. And how much does he make? What does he do for a living?
Wow, you really just asked that, huh? Not where he's from, or what he does, or how many brothers and sisters he has. Just straight to the money question.
What? Of course I asked that. It's my duty as your mother to ask that. So tell me, does he make six figures?
Yeah, no. I'm not telling you that because I don't know that. It's not my business and it's certainly not yours. But he does work for a big company, so he's probably doing pretty well.
Oh, a big company. I see. That must mean he went to a good university too, right? Ivy League? Big Ten? And how about his parents? What do they do? I bet they own businesses.
I think you told me they do something with real estate. I guess they own a few properties or something like that. That's all I heard.
Well, jackpot! You got a winner! He's a university grad and works for a great big company, and his folks are in real estate? This guy checks all the right boxes. What a catch! I mean, a guy like this is gonna be wasted on you, don't you think?
I actually kind of agree with you on that, Mom. He's too good for me, and I'm really lucky to have him.
So, what's this guy's name?
Julian. His name is Julian. I was thinking that I want to introduce him to you all sometime, if you won't act like idiots when you meet him.
Julian? I see. Oh, there's plenty of time for introductions. Later, dear. First things first. For now, why don't you give me his number so I can check him out for you? You know, as a mom, I need to thoroughly examine him and his credentials.
Huh. Okay, I guess. Well, I don't mind giving you his number, but what's the examination all about? What are you planning to do?
Oh, don't concern yourself with that. Just give me his number. Anyway, we're about to go have a swim and then get dinner. So talk to you later. I'll be waiting for your text with Julian's number. Delaney, it's me, your beautiful sister. Listen up. I have really big news to share with you.
Big news? What's going on? Did you finally graduate middle school?
Ha ha. Very funny, but I really do have great news. Yeah, it's really sudden, but I'm getting married. I mean, we just went for the marriage license, so it's official. Even though we haven't done a ceremony or anything yet.
Wow, married? That's big. And the paperwork's done and everything. That was really fast.
Yeah, it happened fast. But, you know, I met my soulmate, and we just went and did it. Mom met the guy somewhere, and she introduced us. Wow, he's like a dream guy too. He checks all the boxes. Good job and good salary. Plus, he's pretty much my type too. As soon as I met him, I just knew he was the one. So we're married.
Sounds like it was a real whirlwind romance. You sure didn't waste any time. But I'm happy for you and hope you have a great life together.
Thanks. It means a lot, sis. But I really hope seeing me with him doesn't make you too sad to be alone, you know? I mean, you'll find someone for yourself sooner or later, I'm sure. A new someone, I mean.
Huh? Why would I be sad about any of this? I don't get it. You're my sister, so of course I wish you happiness. Why wouldn't I?
Do you really? I think you got to be at least a little upset about this, though. I mean, you gotta be sad about your sister taking your boyfriend from you. I'm talking about Julian, silly. I'm sorry, but I had to do it. Like I said, it's official and we're married now. The wave came and I rode it.
Excuse me? Please repeat that last part. You just went and got your marriage license with my boyfriend, Julian. Is that what you said?
Yeah, now you get it. Mom introduced us a while back. Isn't that hilarious? She's always thinking of me. Mom was saying he wasn't a good match for you. You know, he's just so handsome and eligible. She kept saying I'm a much better match for him, and she was right.
Did you say Mom introduced you to him? That's interesting.
Yeah, and I mean, wow. He's got a great job, and his parents are big in real estate and everything. Like, what a catch he is. And he really likes me, too. He's always telling me how cute I am and doting on me, just like Mom and Dad do. He's totally into me. Like, totally. And it looks like he's totally over you, sis. Also, like, totally.
Wait a minute. I need to process all this. Let me get this all straight in my head. You and Julian got married. You're my sister, and you just married my boyfriend. And the person who introduced you was Mom. And she did that knowing that he's my boyfriend and with the intention of making this happen. Do I have all that straight?
Yep, 100% straight. I just married your boyfriend. Oops, I mean your ex-boyfriend, Julian. Yay for me! And yes, it was all Mom's doing. So you can thank her.
I hate to break it to you, sis, but I think you have the wrong guy. My husband is sitting here right next to me.
What? Your husband?
And it also looks like I guessed right that Mom was up to something. She's not nearly as smart as she thinks she is. See, I had a feeling. Something ridiculous like this was going to happen as soon as Mom started asking me about my boyfriend. I knew she couldn't possibly be that interested in my life without some kind of angle she was working. And now we know what that was. It's just a good thing I decided to tell Mom a story with some random guy's name.
Huh? A story? What do you mean, a story?
Yeah, sorry, but I had no choice. You people have left me with no choice, once again. And I know you were feeling great, thinking that you and Mom got one over on me, but you didn't. Whoever that guy Julian is, he's not my boyfriend. Ex-boyfriend or anything of the kind. Actually, I don't even have the faintest idea who it is that you just married. But whoever he is, I still wish you all the happiness in the world with him.
Wait a minute. What's going on here? You're saying Julian isn't the guy you've been dating all this time? That can't be right. You told Mom he is. And she told me he is. That's why she introduced us in the first place. And that's why we just got married with Mom and Dad's and Julian's parents' full approval.
Wow. Where should I begin? First of all, you remember me telling you about my boyfriend, right?
Yeah, it was when you came for my birthday, and we were all at the lake without you. We were all like, how in the world did that ugly, boring Delaney ever land a man?
Yeah. So anyway, right after that, Mom called me, acting like she wanted to know how I was and how everything's going. I knew that was fake because she never cares about how I am or how things are going. And then she started pumping me for information about my boyfriend. That's when I realized she was up to something. So I just gave her a guy's name and number from my phone's recent contacts.
What? What random guy?
The fact of the matter is that my husband, Marcus, doesn't work for a great big company. He's self-employed, running his own little company, and I'm actually working with him in that company. We're partners in both business and in life. Oh, and we got married last month. It was a small, intimate affair. And, as you know, you weren't invited. That was intentional.
I'm in shock. How did you make all that happen? So your man is running his own company? Meaning you're the wife of a company president?
Well, that's definitely one way to put it. It's not something I think about a lot, to be honest. Just because it's not really a big deal. Well, like I said, it's just a small company. But there's potential.
But still, he owns a company? He must be making good money.
Yeah, he's doing pretty well for himself. He's his own boss, after all. I mean, we're living well and we don't have any money worries, if that's what you're talking about.
You liar! I can't believe you hid him from us. You really have some nerve misleading us like that. Is that how you treat family? And not just me. You lied to Mom, too? How could you?
Oh, really? That's what you're upset about, that I lied to you? Huh! In this family, that's standard operating procedure. You of all people should know that.
What? What's that supposed to mean?
How many times have the three of you lied to me? How many times have you misled me? How many times did you intentionally tell me the wrong place to meet you all? Tell me how many. I'll tell you how many. So many times that it's obvious that lying and misleading are no big deal to you people. So many times that you could even say that lying is as natural to you people as eating, drinking, and sleeping are. That's how many.
You're way out of line. Those excuses hold no water at all.
I don't need excuses. I have a reality and a lifetime of bad memories to back me up. You know what's true, Sienna. Don't even try to deny it.
Whatever, crybaby. What I want to know is, who's this guy I just married? Who is this Julian and where did he come from?
Oh, him. He's one of Marcus's old college buddies. Pretty nice guy. But a little insecure, maybe. I met him with Marcus at his college reunion recently. He was complaining to Marcus about how he couldn't even get a date, let alone find a great wife like Marcus did. He asked us to give his info to any women we know who might be interested in meeting a guy like him. He was really insistent about it, actually. So I took his number just to humor him and get him off our backs. Then, when Mom started interrogating me about Marcus, I had a sudden flash of inspiration. Julian and Sienna! Yeah, that's the ticket.
Then Julian's just some random classmate from Marcus's college days, and he wasn't even your boyfriend? And I just married him? I married him because he was supposed to be your boyfriend. Don't you get it?
Yeah, I get it. You and Mom conspired to steal my man from me, but I was too smart for both of you. Don't worry, I totally get it, sis. But don't be too sad. I mean, he's not my man, but the rest is all true. He really does work for a big company. And his parents really are in real estate, after all. I learned all that about him at the reunion. You still got married to a guy who checks all your important boxes. So you can feel good about that, at least. Anyway, congrats again on getting married. And I'm wishing you and Julian all the best. Marcus and I are very happily married. And I hope you will be too.
You dirty little liar. You completely fooled us. You've got some nerve. How could you stoop so low? You lied right to my face about your husband. Is that how I raised you?
That's exactly how you raised me, Mom. You reap what you sow, as the saying goes. How do you like me now? The real question is, don't you have anything to say to me after what you did? You blatantly tried to set up my boyfriend with Sienna. Talk about nerve.
You shut your lying mouth. You have no idea what you're saying. There's nothing wrong with trying to take care of my baby. Nothing. Sienna's beautiful and we love her to pieces. She's an absolute treasure. And the boys all know it. It'd be totally irresponsible for us not to set her up with an inappropriate man. Lord knows her own judgment certainly can't be trusted.
Ah, there it is. That's my mom. true to form, shouting accusations and self-serving excuses when she should be apologizing. I don't know who did what to you to make you this way, but I knew you wouldn't be able to bring yourself to apologize to me, Mom. What I didn't imagine, however, is how furious you're making me. As of today, I am finished with all of you. Done. I've abused and belittled me for the last time. I deserve and have always deserved to be treated so, so much better than any of you will ever treat me. And I am through. Do you hear me?
Ha. Look at you all high and mighty now that you finally landed some loser and got him to marry you. Go ahead and do it. We don't need liars like you in this family anyway. Don't show your face around here again. We have one beautiful daughter, and that's plenty. She landed herself a good husband with a job and money, and that's all we need. You can go kick rocks, ugly duckling. Don't ever come back here. You're not welcome.
I'm way ahead of you, you sorry excuse for a mother. You won't have to kick me around anymore, ever. Have a nice life. I pity you. I truly do.
Delaney, how could you do this to me? How could you lie about all this? Everything's a sham. How could you stoop so low?
Huh? What are you so upset about? I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play innocent with me. You know exactly what I'm talking about. It's about Julian. You told me the only lie about him was that he was your boyfriend. You said everything else was true. That he worked for a big company, but he's just a lowly construction worker.
Huh? Really? Wow. That's definitely not what he told us.
I thought he was a high-ranking employee, but he's just a laborer. And I thought he drove a fancy car to work, but he actually rides in the back of a pickup truck with his coworkers. How could you do this to me, Delaney?
Wait a minute, Sienna. Don't jump to conclusions. I didn't lie to you about any of this. I told you what I knew based on what Julian told Marcus and me at the reunion. If any of that was lies, it wasn't us who lied. It was Julian.
Go ahead and try calling the number on that card and see what happens. Go ahead. Call it right now.
What? Why? What's going to happen?
He gave me one of those cards on our first date too, and I thought it was legit. But today, I tried calling him at that number and it's not in service. Then, I got the company's actual number online and called it asking for him by name. And they told me they have no such employee by that name.
Whoa, looks like you're right. The number on this card is disconnected.
Right? And that's not all. When I confronted him, I discovered more lies. He told me he had $200,000 in the bank. That was a total lie too. In fact, he's actually about that much in debt.
What? Oh, wait a minute. Something's not right here. Marcus is right here with me, and he's nodding his head in agreement. Julian was bragging about those numbers out loud to everyone at the reunion.
He's no shareholder. He shouldn't be $200,000 in debt, no matter how badly he invested in that company. It just doesn't add up. And that story about his folks being real estate investors, also a lie. The only one in his family in real estate is his grandma. And all she is the landlord of a crappy little building behind the Greyhound station.
His grandma, you say? Wow. That's just...
I believed all his lies. All of them. He says he just wanted to feel like he wasn't such a loser. So he made it all up. I can't believe this is happening to me.
Wow, I'm shocked, and so was Marcus. We both thought Julian was the real deal, and that the two of you were a great match.
So, how are you going to fix it for me? It's your fault I got mixed up with this loser. I tried to talk to Mom and Dad about it, but they're ghosting me. Can you believe it?
I hate to say it, but now you know how I feel.
This is not happening. It's just a bad dream. It has to be. I want out of this marriage right now, but Julian won't sign the papers. He says he refuses.
Relax, sis. It's all going to be okay. Take a deep breath and think about the big picture. You're a great liar too, you know? So you and Julian might actually be a match made in heaven.
Oh, just shut up. No match with a deadbeat debtor like this guy is a match made in heaven.
No, no. You two are really perfect for each other. I mean it. And I'm wishing you many, many happy years together. I'm sure your beauty and charm will make all the difference. Just like it always has with Mom and Dad. Bye-bye. I didn't know it at the time, but apparently my parents, who also fell for Julian's lies, just like we all did, actually had gone through the process of legally adopting him into the family. They thought they were marrying into money by proxy. You see the upshot of that seemingly warm-hearted but actually self-serving action was that both Julian and Julian's debts were now part of the family. Sienna could divorce him, but he'd still be there as a result of all this. The once warm relationship between her and my parents has cooled considerably. Currently, Sienna and Julian are both working multiple jobs in order to pay the rent and pay off Julian's creditors. They show up uninvited regularly and are impossible to ignore.